another one there, look at that.
Oh, whoa!
One take. Yes, beautiful.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to another episode of Hoodstick. I'm here with Lord Mikey. Mikey, is it Mikey?
Mickey.
Mickey.
Daddy.
Okay, Lord Mickey.
I like Lord Bit though.
Okay.
Lord Biscuit.
It's nice to have you on the channel.
Cool, nice to have you.
And you know what? This is unbelievable. My first time actually being in Lamborghini. Never been in Lamborghini before. But all I want to say is, how the hell did you end up here? Why did you go for a Lamborghini?
Well, I never thought I'd have one, to be honest, in the first place.
Okay.
I got my own business about 3 years ago. It all went well. Went on from there. Just kept on going. Strength. I did look at I thought Ferrari was a bit too tame. They didn't look that much out there. Lambos, mm-hmm. They do. Absolutely love Lambos. When I was a kid, I was thought, you know what? I love a Lambo. And I thought, I would love to own one day. And then what I thought it could happen, I was thinking, okay, fair enough. You know, I was happy. I was thinking, wow,
yeah.
I got myself a Lambo, I can actually do it. And that it spurred me to hit that first goal. Now, you know, I've got different goals after that. But so I know I can hit certain goals if I work hard.
Mm.
You know, and yeah, that's what it is. It is working hard and just, you know, getting to where you want to get to and have a goal and achieve it.
That's amazing, absolutely motivational, because you've had this for 2 years, is it?
2 years, yeah.
And before that, you never had supercars. Like, I mean, you've got a
Skyline. I had the Skyline, but yeah, I had that, and then I always love cars, love building cars, doing that kind of stuff. But this, I don't touch this. It's just, I will do certain bits in it, but you want to keep the service record all straight. You don't need to mess about with it. It's a pretty decent, you know. He's a spec car. And
tell us the spec about this. Which LP is it? What brake horsepower?
LP 610, 610 brake, four-wheel drive, 5.2 litre V10.
Wow.
I mean, the best thing about this car, I will say, is the handling, right?
Okay, come on.
This car needs more power. I'm going to say, I ain't no race driver, nothing like that. I haven't been in a track. I'd love to, if I get time, I'd love to do it.
Okay.
But you can actually, like, rip this car, put it around corners, and it comes out fine. I mean, I've done it in the winter with my cousin. He went to go look at a car.
Yeah.
I come around this roundabout. I thought I was going to stack into the side barrier.
Yeah.
He looked at me and he thought he thought, it must have been like, it felt like about an hour, but it's a split second. The car just corrected itself straight away.
Yeah,
you can feel the car just correcting itself. I mean, the four-wheel drive system is amazing. Absolutely amazing on it. I said the handling outweighs the power by a lot. It's fast, it's not scary enough though.
No way.
So I think it needs, yeah. And the brakes, carbon ceramic brakes, absolutely. The braking is probably one of the best things about the feature as well with that car. So I was told they don't lock.
It'll
carry on braking, carry on braking, and the brakes won't lock at all. That's what I've been told. I'm not sure. I never had the car lock, but yeah, I mean, I put it through a fair few corners, but.
That's crazy.
And I'd like driving cars. I'm not that experienced about driving. I don't race cars, do anything like that. And for me, this is like, handling is just too good.
Unbelievable. Obviously, from past history, like I said, you've only come through like normal cars. Skyline's your first and the fastest car.
Yeah, that was my first. When I built that engine, I built for 600 brake.
Yeah.
It was a GTS, put a GTR 26 in it, built the engine from scratch. And then, you know, I didn't get a chance to finish it. Then I got this and I thought, I probably will get a Skyline later on when I have more time.
GTR?
Yeah, I'd think about getting a 35.
Have you been in one?
I've been in one, yeah.
Is it faster than this? Because I've never.
It's on the same part, but this you feel the G's more on this, I think. I mean, but you're lower down this.
Yeah.
I mean, the handling on this is just, I can't stress, it's amazing. But if Lambo watching, mate, put more power in this, it needs more power. I thought about twin turboing it.
Yeah.
Which it brings 0-60 down to 1.6.
No way.
Then I don't think you can put a rear bumper on it either. They get rid of the rear bumper.
Oh yeah. We've seen some of them videos. People do that.
Underground racing, yeah. They do some nut stuff. And I sort of like, I was inquiring about it. And then because the car's out of warranty now, so it doesn't really matter. But if you get it done, apparently they warranty danger for 3 years.
No way.
So, but the car has got a 12-year rust guarantee on it.
Oh, so
Lambo done from scratch.
So when it comes to service and stuff, do you have to go to Lamborghini yourself?
I want to keep the Lamborghini stamps on there. I mean, owning the car, it ain't that bad. I've got to get new tyres for it, which are probably about, what, 1,200 quid? But not too bad. They're set at 4, that ain't bad for a car like this.
200.
The servicing, it's about, the standard set charge, I think, is about 2,800.
And how long is that every
year? No, you've got to do it every year. Don't matter, you do 1,000 miles or 10 miles, you do it every year. They do it by every year instead of spec. I mean, to own a car like this without fuel, I mean, it's not that bad of fuel, I'll give it that. And my mate 74 is worse.
And it'll tell you
it is worse. To own a car like this, you're talking about, it's about 2.5 grand a year for servicing. Then you're talking about 300 grand a year for tracking. It's got a tracker on there as well. Yeah. Tax is about £600 a year. You know, about 3.5 grand. And insurance on this, which is the best bit about it, it's about 980 quid.
That's
fully,
it?
Fully comp, yeah.
£980?
Yeah, fully comp, yeah.
That is absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah,
guys.
Yeah.
34 years old, by the way, guys.
I'm old. But that's the reason why the insurance is low.
Okay, let's go for a drive.
Any more questions?
No more questions, man. I'm just a privilege. Again, thank you so much for giving me the chance to sit in a Lamborghini.
For me, I think I spoil it for everyone. Even my mate was saying the other day, he goes, now I look at a Lambo, I go past it.
Yeah.
And he's like, mate, I don't even think, oh man, that's a car. He goes, you've ruined it for everybody. He goes, he just feels it as a normal car. He goes, it's not nothing special anymore. It's true, once you get something that you like and you want, you work hard towards. It's normal again.
I mean, when you first got it, what was your reaction? Was it
do you know what?
Over the moon, or were you like, I can't believe I've got this car?
You got three modes in this. So you got Strider, which closes up all the valves. It's not like, it doesn't pop, it doesn't crackle.
Okay.
Sports is where it pops and crackles, it opens it up, you can hear the car a lot louder.
Corsa,
it hardens up everything. And when you drive that, I've driven that for 30 minutes. I've been in my car with my cousin, and he's like, I'm tired. I'm like, yeah, I'm tired driving it.
Yeah.
I tend to keep it in sports because of course you probably do it on a racetrack where everything's flat. Sports is a bit more forgiving and it's not as hard.
Yeah, of course.
But if you do get one and you get a Lambo and you're in England, make sure you get lifting gear, 100%. Do not buy a Lambo without lifting gear.
Why is that?
Mate, it helps you go over the bump, so the car automatically goes up. You press the button, that's lifting gear there.
Oh, whoa! So you've got that
The
then.
Car, yeah. So if you look on the dash down now, it's got yellow on there. It's got lifting gear in there, so that means the lifting gear's up.
Nah, this is all high-tech, this is. To me, any angle of this car looks absolutely amazing.
Aventador, I think Aventador may be next, it looks a lot better.
Yeah.
The sound. The sound definitely does.
Oh my god.
The pops and crackles are absolutely idiot.
Yeah, they were. We'll have to get a GoPro at some point for the back.
When I first drove it out the place, I was driving like a granny. I was thinking, well, I wasn't used to it. I was like, well, this is no doubt, it's different. Yeah. Then it got really easy to get used to very quickly. Then
yeah.
you start getting more confident, and you start knocking around corners.
Oh man, that sounds so good.
The sound is just the best thing about it, everyone loves the sound.
Yeah.
My mate jumps in, my neighbours, because he's quite a good friend, Richard. He's always like, he turns the radio off and he puts the window down. He's like, mate, I just want to hear the car. I don't want to hear anything else, I just want to hear the car.
You know when you're inside the Lamborghini, it just feels like you're a normal car, but from outside, it's like, oh jeez. That one's fast, man.
Well, so what is it like to own one? All my neighbours, you know, if they want to know what it's like, I take them all out in it. It's like, I'm happy to do that. I enjoy it, but they enjoy it a lot more now.
No, of course.
Than myself.
This is, like I said, this is my first time in a Lamborghini. So.
Okay.
First time in a Lamborghini. Oh, gosh. Again, thank you very much.
No worries, I really appreciate it.
This is a dream come true, and I can't thank you enough.
Sport Mac, so basically foot on the brake.
Foot on the brake.
Yep.
Wow. So that is it going to change yourself?
No, you'll change yourself now.
So to make that's it automatic, now. That's automatic now. So click this now.
It's sort of Mac now. Then go for it. If you click it, it'll take some foot Mac.
Wow. Yeah, that's pretty easy. That is.
So it's not that bad to drive, is it?
No,
It just looks like when you drive one for the first time, you want to concentrate. When I was driving for the first time, I was like to my mate, I was like, can you turn the heated seat off? Because I can't even look at the console right by now.
Everything looks so,
everything's on the steering wheel to make it look like it's just, that's what you're going to concentrate on.
They made it
like it's a driver's car. That's why I put everything on the steering wheel. So the paddles are big, the indicators are on there, the wind wipers are on there, everything's on there.
That's crazy. And so if I just drop this now, wow. That's it, it's a new bit of to the ground, this is.
Yeah.
Wants to make you go faster, but then at the same time you're thinking, oh man, like
how much guts you got really.
Yeah, definitely.
So push your bike together. Yep, neutral, then
park.
P-park, and yeah, then yours work up the handbrake. That's it.
How does it feel like to jump in another car and come back here? Do you ever forget how to drive this?
Nah.
You look at all them kids.
Nah. I told you, you get used to it.
Yeah, of course.
It's normal now.
Man. Oh man, that was unbelievable, man. They all jumped out of the coach just to see that.
But that's what you get, you know. As I said before,
I've never seen that.
With Lambo, it just makes people happy for some reason.
Oh man. Yes.
It definitely was, and when I just realised if I can't work it, I can get one off. It's like the feeling. It's like I can imagine myself in that car now.
Wow.
And I see the story about it. I chased this car down everywhere, and then it was parked outside that place in Ascot, and my mates. And I got it, and I was submitted to buying another one, but because the interior, I wanted this, and yeah, didn't have the Oxford. They messed me about a bit. Couldn't find it. Saw a couple off that with red interiors, but I liked one. I thought, John, I'm going to buy one now. And I said to him, yep, I'll have it. On the way back, driving through Ascot to my mates on off chance, it's parked outside the Super Ventura. And I rang my mate. I said, look, it's there. It's the unrolled crap clothes. He's in his high vis, just got back from work.
Yeah.
Jumped in my BMW, went there, said to mate, I'm going to buy this car that night. He goes, mate, I haven't put it for sale yet. He goes, right, that night he gave me a price. I go, right, let's work it out on this. And next day, put deposit down for it. And then following, I think, about a week later, you need to get MOT'd and, you know, checked over and detailed. About a week later, I went down, paid the rest of the balance, picked up the car.
Jeez, I bet it's money can't buy at that moment.
No, but it's a small piece of paper like this when you see how much you spent in the car there.
That's something that we don't want.
A small receipt, yeah.
No way. Right then,
you good?
Thank you very much.
I love a tower, Lord, man.
Thank you so much for that, and I can't. literally, I'm mind blown right now, and I can't even explain to you how much I can appreciate and thank you so much for this.
Hey, no worries.
If you guys enjoyed that, and you know, I'm speechless, and there's nothing more that I can say. So, peace, guys.
As long as you're happy.
Yeah, I'm mind blown.